Oh boy, Suicide Squad Mondays are back. Yes, as you might recall, back when they were filming Suicide Squad, at least the exteriors up in Canada, every Monday, like clockwork, at least for a few weeks, we would get a fresh batch of set leaks. And as I said back then, I think those set leaks did a lot of good for Suicide Squad because they've allowed us, the fans, to kind of wade in to the waters of this new movie instead of having to cannonball in. So yes, when we first dipped into tow, they were frigid and unwelcoming waters, but I have to say, at this point, and we are pretty far out from the movie still, I've become quite comfortable in this water, and it's almost reaching jacuzzi levels. Yes, that's how happy I am with the way Suicide Squad is developing. So we're going to go over these photos today that are not a set leak, but are courtesy. They're intentionally distributed through Empire Magazine. And I have to say, they are a welcome change from the total film coverage of Batman v Superman from last week, which really didn't show any new images at all. I mean, they had a couple of reveals in the text of the article, but nothing that was like a huge like game changer. Nothing that was like these photos, right? So once again, Suicide Squad keeps overshadowing Batman v Superman, which is something they have to fix in the Warner Brothers publicity department. But it's really an embarrassment of riches, and I'm very excited for both of these movies next year because I think not only because they look so good, but also just to be honest, I'm ready for a change of pace. You know, Marvel has been dominating the space for so long and really had no competition that it's not like against Marvel, by the way, but it's just, again, as I said, a change of pace. Now, here's the cover that everyone's going gaga about. And just for fun and for comparison, let's compare it to the Empire cover for Heath Ledger's Joker back in the day. And you can see a real, they're both very visually arresting, but you can see, I think, a real reflection of the societies that produce both Jokers. You know, like Heath Ledger's is very like Dapper Dan, kind of like the anarchist. You know the person I'm talking about, right? Whereas, and I think they also reflect the actor playing them. I did a comics to film with Alan Kistler talking about the Joker, and we said that the Joker always reflects the horror films of the time period that he's in, right? So I've always thought that was very interesting. But I think that also we have to factor in that the actor who plays him, at least with these two, brings in their own personal interests, right? I mean, Heath Ledger was very much an artist. He was kind of part of that, you know, Dapper Dan-like community as well. Well, Jared Leto, meanwhile, is very interested in the arts, right? I mean, this is a guy who has his own rock band, 30 Seconds to Mars. He's very interested in the world of art. And so I think that he's kind of turned his Joker like into Kanye West, right? And I have to say, Kanye West, there's a lot of BS you have to sort out, but there's genius in there. And I think there's going to be genius in this performance. So again, we're going to start with this cover and then go through the different photo reveals. There are some really good ones. So the cover, there's so much going on here. Now, of course, it does confirm that those tats are not going anywhere. And I've come to like them because, as I've said in my coverage before, I think that it mirrors what today's criminal element looks like. You know, tats, you know, of course, were very popular with the Russian mob, right? That's always been a big thing. But with a lot of the gang warfare you see going on today, particularly in Los Angeles, where, of course, David Ayer is, heavily influenced by all of his films that he's ever made, that's a big part of the gang community. So it makes sense that his Joker would have those. Even the forehead tattoo, which thankfully is so delicate that it can be bleached out by lights when filming. But also you can see joke written across his stomach, and he's got smiley faces apparently all over him, which is good because it doesn't require his Joker to smile all the time. And I would also like to point out that this is the first time we've seen a Joker, at least in the movies, that hasn't scarred his face, right? It's just his own natural smile. And Jerome on Gotham did that as well, and I thought both were surprisingly effective. You would think you need to have the scars or the exaggerated smile, but no, I think you now have two actors proving that that's not necessary. Although not to take anything, of course, away from the brilliant visuals of Heath Ledger's performance. Now here, I love the fact that he has his Arkham sweatpants on still, right? Like, it's very similar to, a lot of today's gangs, of course, still represent their favorite sports teams and, you know, brands, designer brands. And of course, I think it's wonderful that the Joker would have Arkham as his favorite brand, right? It's like, it's wonderfully self-referential. And he's like, I like these pants, they're comfortable. And even though I'm not in Arkham anymore, I'm going to keep them on. So I think that's great. great. And also, I think, you know, it just really emphasizes, like, that's where I'm supposed to be, but I'm not, which makes it even scarier. Now, he's barefoot, and we've seen a Joker rock the barefoot look before, but nobody liked it, and everyone laughed at it. But I think it's that Jared Leto is owning this so much that it works, right? Like, you know, he's like, these are my creative choices, and I own them, I stand by them, and they're great, and just wait till you see them in action. And I think he's slowly winning people over. Now, what is a little bit, I think, is going to make people feel a little bit more comfortable with this is some of the callbacks to classic Joker apparel, right? The cane, very Jokery, and I think that does throw back a little bit to his Dapper Dan, you know, gentleman clown killer origins. You know, he's always, you know, for a while there, he was always pretty darn well dressed, right? I mean, Joker's usually shown in a suit. So I think the cane adds that element of dress up, right? Also, doubles as a weapon, so it's all good. And then I love the choice of the coat. I wonder if this is the coat with better lighting that we've saw in the trailer, with my favorite shot of the Joker, by the way, where he's going through that facility with a bodyguard in front of him, and he just looks like the coolest mob boss ever, right? Or gangster boss in this case. And it's a similar coat, so I wonder if it's actually this coat. But the purple, although don't wear that coat around Killer Croc, right? I do not think he would take too kindly to that, although I don't think the Joker cares. But anyway, it looks like crocodile skin dyed purple, naturally. Although it does reflect the blue on the pants, which I also think is very interesting. So I'm curious as to, you know, if that's in the dye or if it's kind of a somewhat reflective material. But the purple, of course, is the Joker's signature color, but we've never seen him quite dressed like this. Quite ever as stylish as this. And the slick back hair, I just think it's a really great look. I couldn't like it more, actually. And I'm really curious to see what Jared Leto does with this character. And I'm again, fascinated by how much of himself he's injected into it. Now let's move on to these other photos, which are fantastic. We've got two photos here. It's a two-page spread, so I've put them together here for you. And this is wonderful, obviously, of course, because it mirrors Batman the Animated Series, right? I mean, how awesome is that? You've got Joker sitting across the table from Dr. Harleen Quinzel, although I believe that Cara Delevingne sports this look at some point as well, so maybe she's going to break into Arkham pretending to be Harley Quinn, because I guess Harley Quinn is so zonked at that point from the therapy that the Joker has given her that she can't even double for herself, which is interesting because Harley Quinn's often done that in the comics, so to rob her of that ability would be an interesting development, right? She's always been able to go back to the Harley Quinn, the Harleen Quinzel persona, be it to be undercover, to have a kind of an alter ego if she wants to have a break from being Harley Quinn. But so if to take that away from her would be very interesting indeed. But having them sit across from each other is fantastic. And also reminds me, of course, of Batman sitting across from Heath Ledger's, you know, Christian Bale's Batman sitting across from Heath Ledger's Joker in The Dark Knight. So, you know, the Joker, you know, he has a lot of dinner dates. But, you know, the look on his face, I think, is really interesting. And, you know, he has no eyebrows to kind of create more of a skull look. So, you know, his facial expressions, I think, are going to be really interesting. But I don't think we've ever quite seen the Joker look like that. Although I have to say, at this moment, he does not seem to be seducing Harley Quinn, right? He seems to be more to, you know, mocking her or something. And he has the pants on there. But he seems to have some kind of Arkham shoes on, though. I think that he has like sandals on or something. But I'm glad he's in a straitjacket. I think clearly, you know, they should have kept him in that. But I think it looks absolutely fantastic. And he seems to though have the metal teeth, and I don't know why they would allow him to keep those in Arkham. All right, so the next shot is a wide shot of that, which also reminds me very much of the Batman Joker sit down, because there are a lot of famous shots that often make the rounds on the internet of that scene from a behind the scenes perspective. So it's interesting. I don't know if that was intentional to mirror the iconicness of that with this shot. But this looks great as well. Of course, Joker is front and center because he's the most important. But although don't underestimate Harley Quinn, I think this character is going to take off like a rocket, no matter how she's portrayed, no matter how faithful it is to the original, I think it's going to do really well. And this duo, of course, I think is largely powering the popularity of this movie before it even comes out. But looks great. Arkham looks suitably crappy. I really actually am fascinated by insane asylums. I've read a lot of the history of insane asylums. I think a lot of people are. I've actually read the manual on how to diagnose, insanity, different, you know, levels of insanity. And I think that a lot of people are. And I think that's one of the reasons that Batman's Rogues Gallery is so popular, because it really taps into that interest. But, you know, great scene. Then this is the rest of the photo. This is the last good, like, really different photo. And this one looks great. This is obviously Amanda Waller giving, I think that's someone holding a script, actually, maybe giving notes on the scene. Now, I'm not quite sure who Amanda Waller would be briefing, because she said this, you know, in the opening scene of the trailer, the first trailer from Comic-Con, that this is a secret organization that's largely off the books. And if that ever does come to light, they have no culpability because they've hired these criminals. But I think I think that Viola Davis looks very much in charge as Amanda Waller. I'm curious to see her choice, you know, which direction she goes with the character. There are now two versions that exist, both very popular. But I think we're all going to be curious to see who's at this table and who she's briefing. And of course, I think the photos behind her look great. Now it's unfortunate for Will Smith that I believe you can tell by the ears that she's behind. He's behind Amanda Waller. He's probably like, damn it, she couldn't have taken the photo from a different angle. Although maybe it's intentional, because I think Will Smith isn't the most popular person there is right now when it comes to audiences. But the order, I bring it up, that's why I bring it up. I think that's very interesting that you would have Harley Quinn first, Will Smith's dead shot, Killer Croc, Captain Boomerang, Slipknot, and then El Diablo at the end there. And so it also, you know, Katana's not on there. I mean, it might just not have room for the whole lineup. But then also that it maybe feeds the idea that Enchantress, as some people are guessing, is the villain of this piece. And she's, you know, taking the exact storyline from the first arc of Justice League Dark. So, you know, really taking what they need from the different comics and being like, sorry, Justice League Dark movie that Scott Rudin is now producing and Guillermo del Toro probably is not directing. We're making Suicide Squad now. Find your own storyline. All right, so anyway, I do like the photo. These photos are great because these last two really remind me a lot of the way we've always seen these characters. So I think it's giving a little bit of the familiar to balance out the strikingly new. Now we also have this photo of Harley Quinn in her cell with her sporting her own tats. I don't know what they, I get, it looks like she ripped up, her bed sheets and made that that swing set for herself. As I said in my shot-by-shot review of this trailer, I like that it creates the idea of Harley Quinn as a bird in a cage. I think that's very interesting. However, I still continue to wonder what the character will lose in exchange for these new qualities that David Ayer is imbuing her with. So we'll see. I think, as I've said, I think that she's clearly based more on the video game version, the Batman Arkham version of the character, than anything we've seen in the comics or in the animated series. Now, a lot of you like to say, Paul Dini has signed off on this. Brian Michael Bendis has signed off on Jessica Jones. These are company people who continue to work for these companies. They are 100% going to sign off on these movies. Now, I'm not saying they're wrong, but don't take any creator's stamp of approval as a good sign or as a guarantee if they still work with the company in question, okay? I mean, their boss calls them up and says, we need you to say this is awesome. And they're like, okay, where do I say it? All right, so the last two photos that we have are of the Enchantress, and these are pretty much taken exactly from the trailer. So this is kind of reminding me of the Batman v Superman coverage, right? Where you're like, I've already seen this, but thanks for the cool still that I can now add to my collection. I think this one shot of Enchantress. She has a little bit of Huntress vibes, actually. I think it looks pretty good. The characters look, this is obviously her, and her whatever villain form she's going to take. We'll see how Cara Delevingne does here. Her movies have been tanking, Paper Towns and Pan, and she might actually end up being somewhat of a liability for this movie, or it could be finally her breakout role, which allows her to really do something really interesting. Because I have to say, she had like no role in Pan, but in Paper Towns, I thought she did a nice job. So I think she's a good actress, which is rare for models. So I'm willing to give her the benefit of the doubt here. And I do think that this photo of her in the black goo, and that's of course the pentagram behind her, I think it's cool and it makes, interested in what's happening to her. But it's going to be tough to beat the Michelle Pfeiffer transformation scene from Batman Returns for Catwoman. And I think nobody wants to seem like they're, borrowing too heavily from it. This also differs vastly from the origin story of Enchantress in the comics, which you can learn about if you watch episodes of Suicide Squad Files, Case Files, here on Beyond the Trailer. I'm going to link to a few of those right now and in the video description. All right, so that's my review of these shots. Fantastic play by Warner Brothers Publicity Department, and I am very, very excited for this movie. All right, share your own thoughts down below. Thank you for tuning in, and you can check out some other episodes right now.